As our city council meets this evening to do the work of serving this community of Corona,
Cub Scout Pack 134, who are going to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I will pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
Thank you so much for leading us in that Pledge of Allegiance. At this time, I would like to call the meeting to order.
So because of your actions, we are very fortunate enough to say that you saved somebody's life.
So this evening, we are recognizing Parks and Rec Commissioner Elizabeth McCreary. I love you. Thank you so much for everything you've done for me and the city. Okay.
We have Mr. Dan Perez, founder and CEO of Shield for Kids.
In 1983, President Reagan signed a proclamation stating that the nation will observe April as Child Abuse Awareness Month. Nelson Mandela, who said, "History will judge us by the difference we make in the everyday lives of our children."
We have a presentation from Ms. Cynthia Lara.
Tonight's presentation is just a brief overview of the COVID-19 programs that have been launched in our city since June of 2020. And so between the rental and the mortgage assistance program, we have assisted 85 households. And what that translates to is 238 persons impacted by that assistance.
Presentation on McKinley Grades Separation Quarterly Update.
Good evening, Madam Mayor and members of the City Council. I'm going to show you various aerial views here just so that you can get a perspective on the proposed project. This aerial view here shows what the project will look like when completed.
Chief Young will provide an update on our COVID-19 situation.
Some great news just continues to happen as far as the total numbers of cases we're seeing. Once again, we only saw 20 new cases in the past week, and we have not experienced a COVID-related death in well over a month. So great news continues to trend positively. You can see we have 50% of our population fully vaccinated, and 63 either partially or fully. So great news there, contributing to our positive trends we're seeing.
Are there any speaker cards or written comments from the public for the proclamations and presentations?
I'm curious. I would think that any significant settlements would come to the council.
So you can track the closed session agendas. They'll indicate the properties that are involved in any particular discussion.
Let's jump into the next item on our agenda, which is meeting minutes. That item passes 5-0. And I think we're going to have Ms. Roper.
It's really beneficial for a city to have a strategic plan because it is a guide for elected officials and the public to know if staff are on track and investments that are made by your council and every action that we do, if it is pointing back to the plan. Thought it would be really cool to give you guys a success story because these are always really heartwarming to know how the programs are changing and transforming lives. So super excited that we are a shining star to show good collaboration from one city, between two cities.
Once the council agenda is issued, council members are encouraged to ask questions from the time of issuing to minutes before the meeting if necessary.
This is not an exclusive agreement, so we are definitely shopping around at other areas as well.
We'd be happy to look at other options. We do need to have a contract in place, so we do recommend that we proceed with this item, and we could always come back with some other alternatives if there is some desire from council to explore, you know, different purchasing consortiums.
I support moving forward with it now, but I also would like to see staff research some lower prices if there's any other companies that can do it cheaper.
What type of checks and balances are we doing to verify that we're getting the best price, or that, you know, our orders are complete and on time, or they're full?
You know, I feel like we've got a lot of experts in the field of just construction and supplies on the dais, and so I want to defer to your expertise. And so what's the pleasure of the council on this item? And that item passes 4-1. Thank you.
It does take a new vendor a little bit of time to get up and get familiar with all of the routes of Corona.
Would the business owner like to say anything?
Thank you, Mayor. This is Jeff Hick, the regional manager.
You know, at the end of the day, we're all humans trying to do the best that we can, but we are certainly your partners in keeping the streets of Corona clean and tidy for the residents. And that is truly what it's all about. This is a partnership, and we'll work together to do the best that we can.
Good job, team. Okay. let's go on to communications from the public.
I'm here to respectfully request that this governing body remove the bike lanes that have been placed on Collett Avenue through the Monterey Complex.
Just to let you know, staff is looking into this one. There's a little bit of history.
The Corona Fire Department is pleased to announce the implementation of a new program to better serve our community. Members of our department who live within the city have been provided with automated external defibrillators, or AEDs.
And we're here tonight to say thank you to you and to our community and share the names of the folks that supported our program. Our initial outreach was $20,000 to buy them for the 20 firefighters in town, and in less than 4 months, we've reached that goal.
I think you pitched in for the very first AED, so thank you for getting the ball rolling.
Today, I'm here to introduce a new business that is opening in Corona, or has just opened.
Okay, with that, we close out communications from the public.
So this evening, we are presenting for your consideration a professional services agreement with the Corona Chamber of Commerce. So here in the Office of Economic Development, we are fortunate to have extensive partnerships with a robust network of resource agencies, locally, regionally, statewide, and federally.
Ms. Edwards, are there any speaker cards or written comments from the public on this item?
The Corona Chamber membership is comprised of 90% small businesses. And Mayor Jackie Casillas recently commented that the city's goal is to reinvest in our community.
As a city, we pride ourselves on being business friendly, and the Corona Chamber of Commerce represents and advocates on behalf of this diverse and evolving business community.
Coming out of COVID, it's never been as important to support our business community at the highest level that we can.
For the atmosphere that you've created, the excitement that you've created, a lot of people love you. You guys give a home to a lot of businesses that are looking to thrive, and you pave those ways forward.
What a great story. I did not know that the whole, you know, stay-at-home mom to CEO. I love it. I absolutely love it.
Vice Mayor Speak, do you have questions, comments?
I'm happy to see it go forward. I 100% support the chamber and what they do. You know, they are amazing advocates for not only the city, they are our biggest cheerleaders.
I agree. The chamber is tireless in their support of businesses and in their advocacy and in support of the city.
And now to the all-important species of the month. This month, we are celebrating the double-crested cormorant.
All right. So with that, tonight's meeting is adjourned. Thank you.